My name is Christopher Loverro. I'm a participant in the Diavolo Veterans Dance Program and the founder of Warriors for Peace Theater.
The piece just shows this intensely beautiful connection between us as veterans and our connection to our personal journeys.
My name is Jacques Heim. I'm the artistic director of Diavolo Architecture in Motion. When you work with non-professional dancers, non-movers, they do it in their own way, but it's real, it's authentic.
Be strong to find myself, find faith in each other, and know that there are other people out there who are struggling in their own way.
Dance is an outlet for anybody. Dance is a way to take feelings and emotions that can be trapped inside somebody and find another way to articulate them.
Doing this veterans program through Diavolo has been the best form of therapy I've ever had. I mean, I've done numerous programs through the VA. This is the first time I have truly felt at peace since I returned from Iraq.
I'd like to start by saying it's an honor for all of us to be up here. Thank you so much for caring about this very, very important issue. I'm just going to start by telling you a little bit about my personal experience with art and my military background. On 9/11, like most of you, I watched in horror as 3,000 Americans were murdered. After seeing this, I volunteered to go to Afghanistan. I wanted payback. I wanted to be a part of the operation to hunt down and destroy the people who attacked us. Finally, in 2003, my Army Reserve unit was accepting volunteers. But after being mobilized, we were diverted to Iraq, where I served in Mosul for a year while attached to the 2nd Infantry Division's Striker Brigade Combat Team out of Fort Lewis, Washington. My job was to safeguard civilians on the battlefield, and I was able to provide humanitarian assistance to over 2,000 displaced refugees. Serving our military and being a part of the global war on terror was the most seminal experience of my life. It also greatly affected me. I was in combat all the way up until the week I flew home, and I could not get the war out of my head. It was like it played like a movie inside my head nonstop. Constant reoccurring images of dead children haunted me. I was hypervigilant at all times. I was always angry. I couldn't sleep. I was depressed. And it felt like the war was like a lead blanket lying on top of me, suffocating me. It was as if my body was home, but my mind and spirit were still in Iraq. I couldn't escape this pain, and one night I decided the only way to be free from it was to take my life. I self-medicated with a bottle of Jack Daniels and sat in my living room with a loaded Glock pistol in my mouth. I started to pull the trigger. It wasn't that I wanted to die. It's just that I couldn't bear living anymore. Something stopped me, and the next day I went to the Oakland Vet Center and I got help. I reluctantly admit that at times it feels as if the war broke me. There is a loss of innocence that you can never get back. I was extremely proud to defend our great nation, and I would do it again without hesitation. But I can tell you that our war fighters are not machines. We are human beings, and war is not a natural human endeavor. When you spend a year of your life with people actively trying to kill you every day, it can take a toll on your soul. So for the next 10 years, I tried everything I could, every form of therapy, to become whole again. I battled with depression, and at times I was overcome with despair. Then I found Diavolo, and for the first time in a decade, I have finally been at peace. Diavolo takes veterans on an intense journey like no other. It's a journey of discovery, a journey of facing your demons in ways that no other form of therapy can. A model of exploring movement and dance, and the way it frees us has enabled me to let go of my anger, see the beauty in myself and others, and has provided me the tools to live a positive, productive life. Specifically, Diavolo uses a model that replicates the sense of tribe that many veterans long to have again. It then builds on the trust that we have within this community and challenges us mentally and physically in ways that make us realize the barriers that have shackled our lives are merely illusions, and that we have the power and resiliency to overcome them. There are only a couple times in my life when I have fully felt that I was living in the moment, combat, and performing with Diavolo. I have finally found true catharsis. Our program has been so successful that we were invited to the Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C., where we performed to sold-out crowds in the nation's most prestigious performing arts center. I think it's critically important that California supports art-based programs as a means of helping our veterans to deal with reintegration issues and help them with the process of healing. Art-based strategies help rehabilitate and heal, and Diavolo is at the forefront of successfully integrating these types of programs into the veterans community. Our goal is to make this into a national program, but we want to start here in our home state. With 2 million veterans, California has the largest veterans population in the country. Sadly, the insanity of war is still a defining characteristic of our species. Whereas war reveals the ugly side of humanity, art is the defining characteristic that reveals the positive side of humanity. Diavolo provides an opportunity for our war fighters to regain their humanity and heal from the negative effects of combat and military deployments. It's a model that also provides a bridge to the civil-military divide. Less than half a percent of the U.S. population has taken on the entire burden of fighting our wars in the last 16 years. Other than military families, virtually no one in American society is affected by these wars, and the gap in understanding our veteran population is growing wider. This is problematic, because in order to successfully reintegrate our veterans back into civilian society, that society has to have some stake in understanding of the veteran population. The Diavolo model doesn't just help our veterans like myself heal, but it provides a catalyst of understanding for the civilian population as well. Seeing us perform, hearing our stories, and engaging us in the Q&A after the performances all help further the understanding of what veterans go through, who we are, and what we need, and how you can help. Knowledge about anything does no good unless it's contextualized in a broader understanding of the problem and provides people with a basis on how to act upon that knowledge. Diavolo's collaboration with civilians and veterans provides this crucial piece. In closing, I'd like to say that there are three main issues or areas we need help. Those areas are legitimacy, funding, and expansion. We ask that you help legitimize art as an effective means of helping veterans. We need better access to private and public funding. And we need help with expanding this program beyond the local areas to give other veterans wider access to this and these other programs. I would like to say that the greatest gift that you can give another human being is the gift of life. And Jacques Heim, our director, Jennifer Chang, our executive director, and their dancers have given me that gift. This work has saved my life. I was almost one of the statistics that you read about. I was almost one of those 22 a day. This work, this journey, this process has changed my life and it saved my life, and we want to share it with other veterans. So please support us in this endeavor to positively affect the quality of life of those who are dedicated to keeping our country safe. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.